美国总统拜登在1号的时候发表演说，证实了在上星期日的清晨，中情局的无人机已经在阿富汗的境内击毙了盖达组织首脑扎瓦希里，没有造成平民的伤亡。而这位扎瓦希里被视为宾拉登接班人，在2001年发生的911恐攻就是由这两个人所主导的事件。
美国反恐传出重大斩获，美国总统拜登证实盖达组织首脑扎瓦希里在中情局的无人机攻击中遭到击毙。
And 1 week ago, after being advised that the conditions were optimal, I gave the final approval to go get him, and the mission was a success. None of his family members were hurt, and there were no civilian casualties. Now, justice has been delivered, and this terrorist leader is no more.
这也是相隔11年，美国再度击毙盖达组织领导人。现年71岁的扎瓦希里原本是埃及的眼科医生，一手创办埃及的伊斯兰激进民兵组织。后来他成为宾拉登的左右手与智囊。盖达组织2001年在美国发动911恐怖攻击，外界认为扎瓦希里在幕后策划操刀。此外，包括1998年美军科尔号的军舰恐攻案和美国驻肯亚使馆炸弹恐攻，他也都有参与策划。宾拉登死后，扎瓦希里接下盖达组织的领导位置，美国悬赏2500万美元通缉他，死活不屈。
That after 20 years of war, the United States no longer needed thousands of boots on the ground in Afghanistan to protect America from terrorists who seek to do us harm.And I made a promise to the American people that we continue to conduct effective counterterrorism operations in Afghanistan and beyond. We've done just that.
由于扎瓦希里是在阿富汗首都喀布尔遭到击毙，引发外界质疑塔利班是否为他提供庇护。塔利班政府发言人穆贾希德证实无人机攻击事件，并强烈谴责违反国际原则。不过拜登则强调，美国有决心追缉恐怖分子。
No matter how long it takes, no matter where you hide, if you are a threat to our people, the United States will find you and take you out.
公视新闻郑伟仁编译。